Good morning to all of you. So happy to be amongst all of you to speak to people who are going to be medical doctors. Are you already medical doctors?
Yes.
Oh, you are medical doctors already. So I'm very happy to be able to speak to all of you. So today I want to speak about something that is very important for all of us. That is the human values education. It's part of all education. We got to have human values. You know, there was once a young graduate. He has just got his degree. And he returned home to pay respect to his parents. The parents live in the countryside.
¿Están entendiendo todos o necesitan traducción? Había un joven graduado que estaba regresando a visitar a su padre que vivía en el campo. A su padre que vivía en el campo, pero no había camino. Y él tenía que tomar un bote para hacerlo.
So, the young graduate, there's no road to the village. He had to hire a boatman to take him to the village.
Como no había camino, tenía que contratar a un botero para que lo lleve a su aldea.
So, on the way, because there's no road, the travel took a long time on the boat.
En el camino, como no había camino, tomaba mucho tiempo recorrido.
And the young graduate was very bored.
Y el joven graduado estaba muy aburrido.
So he started to have a conversation with the boatman.
Así que comenzó a tener una conversación con el boatero.
My dear man,
mi querido,
what do you think about global warming?
¿Qué tú piensas de del calentamiento global?
What effect will it have on our location here?
¿Qué efecto va a tener sobre nuestra localidad aquí?
The boatman said, "Sorry, sir, I know nothing about global warming."
Y el boatero le dice, "Lo siento, señor, no sé nada sobre el calentamiento global."
So the young graduate was very disappointed.
El joven graduado estaba muy decepcionado.
You know nothing about global warming.
Tú no sabes nada del calentamiento global.
25% of your life has been wasted.
Has perdido el 25% de tu vida. Has desperdiciado 25%.
So another moment of silence.
Otro momento de silencio.
The young man was very bored with nothing to do.
Y el joven estaba aburridísimo sin nada que hacer.
So again, he started a conversation.
Así que comenzó nuevamente una conversación.
My dear man, what do you think about the economy of the country? Will it improve or not?
Mi querido amigo, dime, ¿qué sabes tú de la economía del país? ¿Piensas que va a mejorar o no?
So the boatman said, "Sorry, sir, I know nothing about the economy."
Y el hombre le dijo, "No sé nada sobre la economía, lo siento."
The young man was so disappointed. You don't know anything. 50% of your life has been wasted. So, another moment of silence, the young graduate was very bored, nothing to do. So he started to ask more questions. My dear man, what do you think about the stock market? The boatman said, "But what is the stock market? What do they sell in the stock market?" I know the market by going to buy fish, vegetables, and so on. What is a stock market? So the young graduate was very disappointed. We don't know anything. 75% of your life has been wasted. Then suddenly the weather starts to change. Clouds covered the area. The wind was blowing very heavily.
El viento soplaba fuertemente.
And the boat was rocking.
Y el bote se sacudía.
And water started to enter the boat.
Y el agua comenzó a entrar en el bote.
Then finally, the boatman said to the young graduate,
el motero le dice al graduado,
"Sir, you know how to swim."
Señor, ¿sabe cómo nadar?
Then the young graduate said, I don't know how to swim. Help me, help me, help me.
Él no sabe cómo nadar. Ayúdame, ayúdame.
So the Lord then said, in that case, 100% of your life is going to be wasted.
100% de tu vida se va a desperdiciar.
So you see, we may know a lot of things. Our education in this world teaches you to be very clever. But you need more than just the normal education. You've got to understand your own life. You've got to have human values so that you can live in this world in peace. So, the first thing we all got to learn is how to find peace in life. You've got to be happy all the time. We say, I want peace.
Nosotros decimos, yo quiero paz.
How are you going to get peace?
¿Cómo vamos a tener paz?
Well, it's very easy.
Es fácil.
There are three words.
Palabras.
We just want the word peace, nothing else.
Nosotros solo queremos la voz paz, nada más.
So you've got to get rid of the I.
Tienen que deshacerse del yo.
Get rid of the want.
Y deshacerse del quiero.
Then you have peace only. So, this is what we need to do.
Eso es lo que necesitamos hacer.
I want peace, you only want peace, get rid of the I, get rid of the what?
Yo quiero paz, solamente queremos paz. Quitemos el yo, quitemos el quiero.
The I is the ego.
El yo es el ego.
When people swear at you, I become angry.
Cuando la gente te insulta, tú te pones molesto.
You're all scientists here.
Ustedes todos son científicos en este lugar.
Let's analyze. When people swear at us, what are they doing to us? Well, there is sound coming into our ears. What is sound? Sound is vibration of air. It consists of oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide vibrating into our ears. You ask any scientist, is it the oxygen that makes us angry?
¿Es el oxígeno lo que nos molesta?
No. Is it the carbon dioxide that makes us angry?
¿Es el dióxido de carbono lo que nos pone molestos?
No. Then it must be the nitrogen.
Entonces debe ser nitrógeno.
Again, no. There's nothing that makes us angry scientifically.
No hay nada que nos convierta en nos moleste, científicamente hablando.
It's only the ego, the I, you are swearing at me, so I am angry.
Es solamente el ego, el yo, tú me estás insultando, entonces yo me molesto.
But scientifically, nothing hurts you at all.
Pero científicamente nada te lastima.
So we got to get rid of the I.
Tenemos que liberarnos del yo.
The second word we got to get rid of is the want.
La segunda palabra en la que tenemos que liberarnos es el quiero.
In the world today, we live in a world where we measure the progress of the country with GNP, gross national product.
Vivimos en un mundo que mide el progreso del país en el producto interno bruto.
So the whole world wants to produce a lot of products.
Así que todo el mundo quiere producir un montón de productos.
We start up all kinds of industries to produce a lot of products.
Que comenzamos un montón de industrias para producir un montón de productos.
Then they say, oh, this is the progress of the country.
Y entonces decimos, ese es el progreso del país.
But when you produce a lot of products, you have to sell them.
Pero cuando produces un montón de cosas, tienes que venderlas.
And when you sell them, you have to produce a lot of wants, a lot of desires from everybody.
Y para venderlas, tienes que producir un montón de quieros, un montón de deseos de cada uno.
So our youth are so much affected. We want this, we want that, we want to buy this, we want to buy that. Oh, and it's creating a lot of problems for our people.
Y así queremos esto, queremos aquello, deseamos esto, y creamos un montón de problemas para nuestra gente.
The more want, the more unhappiness.
Mientras más deseos, más insatisfacción.
Less want, less unhappiness.
Menos quiero, menos insatisfacción.
No want, no unhappiness.
No quiero, menos no insatisfacción.
So you've got to learn to live a simple life.
que hay que aprender a vivir una vida así.
Don't desire this, don't desire that, don't want this all the time, and you get a lot of problems for yourself.
No quiero esto, quiero aquello. Creamos un montón de problemas para nosotros.
So get rid of the I.
Líbrense de él.
Get rid of the want.
Líbrense del quiero.
Then you have a lot of peace.
Entonces tendrán un montón de paz.
So that is what we need to do.
Eso es lo que necesitamos.
Well, I'm going to now give you a little bit of theory of how we learn this life.
Voy a darles algo de teoría de cómo aprendemos en esta vida.
So we're going to do the process of learning.
Voy a enseñarles el proceso de aprendizaje.
And we are all learners.
Todos somos estudiantes.
You know, when I was 60 years old, I still had to learn.
Cuando yo tenía 60 años, yo todavía tenía que aprender.
I was teaching everywhere, universities and in schools and so on.
Yo enseñaba en las universidades y colegios.
The Ministry of Education of Thailand came to me and said, "Sir, you are not allowed to teach. You don't have teaching qualifications."
Y el ministro de educación vino y me dijo, "Señor, usted no puede enseñar. Usted no tiene las calificaciones de educador."
I have PhD in science and engineering.
PhD en ciencia y en ingeniería.
But they said that's no good. You're going to have education.
No, eso no está bien. Tiene que tener educación.
So I had to go back and study for my second PhD in education.
Así que tuve que regresar y estudiar para mi segundo PhD en educación.
Then I'm qualified to be a teacher.
Entonces califiqué para ser maestro.
So now I can teach children.
Ahora puedo enseñar a
los
niños.
I'm just telling you this because you can learn at any age.
Esto se lo estoy diciendo porque ustedes pueden aprender en cualquier edad.
And your knowledge has to be increased all the time.
Y su conocimiento tiene que incrementarse todo el tiempo.
So we have to learn all our life.
Así que tenemos que aprender a lo largo de toda nuestra vida.
So the way we learn,
la forma como aprendemos,
I want you to think that it is the consciousness is very important. As scientists and doctors, you may think the brain is more important.
Como científicos y doctores pueden ser que piensen que el cerebro es más importante.
But the brain is born in the womb of the mother.
Pero el cerebro se formó en el vientre materno.
And when you come out of the womb, you are born, the brain starts to function.
Y cuando salen del vientre materno, el cerebro comienza a funcionar.
By the time you are 20, some of the brain cells are dying.
Y a la edad de 20, algunas de las células cerebrales comienzan a morir.
At my age, I'm 75 now, they said at least a million cells in your brain have died.
Y a los 75 años que tengo yo ahora, por lo menos 1 millón de células han muerto.
But why should I be worried?
Pero ¿por qué debo preocuparme?
I have over 100,000 million cells in the brain.
Tengo sobre 100,000 millones de células en mi cerebro.
So just a million have died, I still have a lot left. And I can still work and still do research and can still find out information. So it's not the brain that is so important. Because when you die, all your brain dies. So you don't need to worry about brain, it has to die one day. What is important is our consciousness, our mind.
Lo que es importante es nuestra conciencia, nuestra mente.
You have to develop this, you have to understand yourself better.
Tienes que desarrollar esto y comprenderse mejor.
So, in our learning process,
en nuestro proceso de aprendizaje,
we have to have information from outside. We receive information by using our five senses.
Información de afuera usando nuestros cinco sentidos.
Then we store all the information in the subconscious mind.
Y almacenamos toda la información en la mente subconsciente.
This is our memory.
Esta es nuestra memoria.
And you never forget.
Y nunca lo olvida.
Whatever you have put into the subconscious, it's always there.
Lo que tú hayas puesto en tu mente subconsciente siempre está ahí.
We may not remember.
Puede ser que no lo recordemos.
Because in order to remember, you have to bring in information from the subconscious to the conscious.
Porque para recordarlo tenemos que llevar información del subconsciente a la mente consciente.
Then you can remember.
Entonces podemos recordar.
So you have psychologists who have experimented with the subconscious.
Así que tenemos psicólogos que han experimentado con el subconsciente.
They use hypnosis to go to the subconscious mind.
Y van, usan hipnosis para llegar a la mente subconsciente.
And when you talk to the subconscious, it remembers everything.
Y cuando le hablan al subconsciente, recuerda todo.
You can ask that person at the age of 4, on that day, at that hour, what are you doing? And you can answer everything.
Le puedes preguntar a la edad de 4 años que a tal hora que hiciste y te puede responder.
And when you are under hypnosis, it's the subconscious that comes out.
Y cuando estás en estado hipnótico, es la subconsciencia la que te manifiesta.
So, we now got to understand about our mind.
Ahora debemos comprender sobre nuestra mente.
There's a king.
Este es un rey.
He had 5 wives.
Tiene 5 esposas.
And he's always afraid of his wives.
Siempre tiene miedo de sus esposas.
Each wife would come along and say, oh, I saw something beautiful, I want it, I want you to get it for me. Then another wife would come along and say, oh, I want to eat this, I would love to have this food, you got to get it for me. All the wives are coming and making a lot of demands from the king. The king is very upset and very unhappy. So he consulted the ministers. All the ministers are male.
Todos los ministros son hombres.
Tell me, how can I not be afraid of my wives?
Dígame, ¿cómo puedo no estar asustado, temeroso de mis esposas?
The minister said, sorry, son, we are also afraid of our wives. So they were all upset, unhappy.
Todos estaban alterados y infelices.
Then they made a plan.
What?
A plan.
Hicieron un plan.
We are going to invite all the male population to a big meeting.
Vamos a invitar a toda la población masculina a un gran encuentro.
On that day we'll have a tent for those who are afraid of the wives.
Y vamos a tener una carpa para aquellos que tienen miedo de sus esposas.
And another tent for those who are not afraid of their wives.
Y otra carpa para los que no tienen miedo de sus esposas.
In this way we'll go and consult the male people who are not afraid, what is their secret.
Y así podemos consultarles a los que no tienen miedo, cuál es su secreto.
So, the day came, and the tent for those who are afraid are filled with male people.
Así que la carpa que estaba llena de los que no tenían miedo, de los que tenían miedo, estaba llena de...
Whereas the tent for those who are not afraid, no man came.
Así que la tienda que no, de los que no tenían miedo, no había nadie.
The king got very upset. Are there no men in this country who's not afraid of their wives?
Y los que estaban muy molestos, no habrá un hombre en este país que no esté temeroso de su esposa.
Then at the last minute, one man did come.
Y en un momento, el último momento, un hombre llegó.
He came to the tent for those who were not afraid.
Y llegó a la carpa de aquellos que no tienen.
The king was so happy he went to see the man.
El rey estaba tan feliz que fue a ver al hombre.
Tell me your secret. How is it that you are not afraid of your wives?
Dime tu secreto. ¿Cómo es aquello de que no tienes miedo de tus esposas?
The man said, I'm also afraid of my wife.
Yo también tengo miedo de mi esposa.
The king said, then why are you in this tent? You've got to go to the other tent.
Entonces, ¿por qué estás en esta carpa? Debes irte a la otra carpa.
The man said, sorry sir, I will not go.
Discúlpeme señor, pero yo no voy a ir.
Why won't you go?
¿Por qué? ¿Por qué no vas a ir?
Because my wife told me to come to this tent. All of us here, we are the king in this story. The 5 wives are the 5 senses. Our eyes see something beautiful. Oh, I want it. Making demand on us. And we are like a king, we comply, we buy things, we get things for them. And the tongue says, oh, I want to taste good food, you must buy it. And we are the king, we comply, we buy everything for all the wives. But we are always unhappy.
nosotros siempre estamos infieles.
So what we need to do is to learn to control the five senses. The wives are the five senses. We've got to control these wives. If you cannot control your five senses and you have a lot of desires, this will harm you and you will not be happy. So, there was one lady. She loves to play music and dance to the music every morning. So she's doing her exercise. And she was dancing by the window. Then she looked out and she saw her neighbor washing clothes. And then after watching the neighbor washing clothes for some time, she would come down and have breakfast with her husband. And she told her husband, "I don't understand it. Our neighbor doesn't know how to wash clothes. The clothes are so dirty." The husband said, "Don't worry. We wash our own clothes clean. That is good enough." But the wife won't listen. She would dance by the window every morning. Then she would observe her neighbor washing clothes every day. Then she comes down to the husband and said again, "Oh, our neighbor, I don't know what kind of washing powder she's using. The clothes are so dirty." So the husband was so bored with all this report. One day, something else happened. The wife came down from upstairs and said to the husband, "Something has happened today. The clothes are so clean. I really want to know what kind of washing powder she's using so we can use the same washing powder." So the husband was laughing away. And he said, "I'm so bored with all your reports every morning. So this morning I got up before you. And I went to clean the windows. The windows are so dirty, so you saw everything dirty outside. But today the windows are clean, so you see everything clean." So if you wear red glasses, you see red everywhere. It doesn't mean red is outside. When you use your eyes to see, sometimes you see something, you point your finger and you say, "That's bad.
A veces tú ves algo, apuntas con tu dedo y dices, eso está malo.
How come?
¿Cómo así?
How can you see something bad?
¿Cómo puedes ver algo malo?
What is it that is entering your eyes?
¿Qué es aquello que está entrando en tus ojos?
Well, we are all scientists.
Nosotros somos todos científicos.
So we say it's light.
Y decimos que luz.
Light is a form of electromagnetic energy.
Y la luz es una forma de energía electromagnética.
Consists of electrical field and magnetic field.
Y consiste de un campo eléctrico y un campo magnético.
This is what is coming into our eyes.
Y eso es lo que está viniendo a nuestros ojos.
So you ask scientists.
Una pregunta a los científicos.
So I see something bad. That is bad.
Y vemos algo y decimos, yo lo veo malo, es malo.
Is it the electrical field that is bringing bad for us to see?
¿Es el campo eléctrico que está trayendo algo malo a nosotros?
Scientists will say, no, nothing is bad, it's vibration of energy, there's nothing bad.
No, y la ciencia mira, no, no hay nada malo, solamente vibración.
Then is it with the magnetic field?
¿Será el campo magnético?
Again, scientists will say, no, the electrical field, magnetic field, they do not contain anything bad.
Los científicos dirán, no, ni el campo eléctrico ni el campo magnético tienen nada malo.
So he asked the scientist, then how come I see something bad?
Entonces, ¿de dónde veo algo malo?
So they said, look at your fingers.
Mira tus dedos.
You point your finger, you say that's bad. But there are three fingers pointing back at you.
Apuntas con tu dedo y estás diciendo está malo, pero hay tres dedos que te están apuntando hacia ti.
So when you see something bad, always look at your own mind.
Cuando veas algo malo, siempre mira en tu propia mente.
In this world, there's nothing really bad.
Este mundo no hay nada realmente malo.
It's only because we think so.
Es solamente porque nosotros pensamos así.
From now on, when we have problems and difficulties,
de aquí en adelante cuando tengamos problemas y dificultades,
you should smile.
Sonría.
Because you need problems to solve so that you can be a better person and be more clever.
Porque ustedes necesitan problemas que solucionar para ser unos mejores.
It's good. It has to happen.
Es bueno y tiene que suceder.
Otherwise, how can we learn?
De otra manera, ¿cómo podemos aprender?
In our life, we must have difficulties.
En nuestra vida, nosotros debemos tener dificultades.
Then we become more clever because of the difficulties we will learn. When we have obstacles in life, be happy. Tell yourself, oh, I'm so lucky today, I have difficulties. I have obstacles. Because we are going to advance, we are going to go forward, we are going to win everything.
Vamos a avanzar, vamos a seguir adelante y vamos a ganar todo.
This is the way you learn.
Es la forma como tú aprendes.
If you don't have any problems, you're not going to learn anything in life.
Si no tienes ningún problema, no vas a aprender nada en la vida.
So everything is good for you.
Todo es bueno para ti.
So I told you about years. People swear to it's only vibration of that.
Yo les dije ya que si ustedes escuchan con sus oídos insultos.
But our problem is how we interpret information.
Pero el problema es cómo nosotros interpretamos la información.
We receive from outside stimuli and we have to interpret that information.
Recibimos de afuera y tenemos que interpretar esa información.
And in order to interpret, you have to bring out something from your memory, the subconscious.
Para interpretar, vamos a tener que tomar algo de nuestra memoria, de nuestro consciente.
So whatever we have put in our subconscious, it will start to bring out that information to interpret information.
Cualquier cosa que hayamos puesto en el subconsciente, tendremos que sacar esa información para interpretar.
When there's something similar, you said, ah, I understand.
Entonces decimos, yo comprendo.
So this is very important process. You understand everything through the information you have put into your subconscious.
Ustedes comprenden todo con la información que han puesto en su subconsciente.
So you've been watching television a lot.
Ustedes han estado viendo mucha televisión.
Young people, they play computer games.
Los jóvenes juegan un juego de computadoras.
And there's a lot of negative information that you put into the subconscious.
Y hay un montón de información negativa que
to see people killing each other.
Hay gente matándose uno a otro.
A lot of problems in the world where we start to have battles, we fight each other.
And
when we read the news, we put all that information into the subconscious.
Cuando leemos la noticia, ponemos toda la información en el subconscio.
So just like the computer,
o como la computadora,
we put information in there and everything is interpreted in accordance with the information in the subconscious.
Ponemos información en el subconsciente y todo se va a interpretar de acuerdo a la información que se ha guardado ahí.
You remember the school in Colorado, United States, Columbine High School.
¿Se acuerdan del Columbine High School en Colorado, en los Estados Unidos?
Two children went into the college and started shooting everybody.
Dos niños fueron al colegio y comenzaron a disparar a todo el mundo.
16 children were killed. And one teacher was also killed. Why? Why did he go out and kill everybody? Well, when they studied the case, they found that these two children went out and killed everybody. They were playing a lot of computer games. In the game they like to play is press a button and you shoot something. But they don't just press the button and shoot. They do this. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Because you have to kill a lot of people in order to score very high marks. And they compete with each other, trying to shoot people and see who can kill the most. And all the time, we're putting into our memory the killing process. So finally, they start to interpret information that we have to kill. Whatever we think, so we become. So in this way, you've got to be very careful what you teach to other people. We ourselves, we've got to be careful what we put into our memory. Always think good things, do good things, put positive information into your subconscious. When you put positive information, it will start to interpret in a positive way. So we've got to teach everyone to think good things.
Pensar cosas buenas.
Do good, give service, help other people.
Hazlo bueno, haz servicio, ayuda a otra gente.
And whatever you think, you start to put information into the subconscious.
Y de lo que pensamos, comenzamos a guardar información en el subconsciente.
You read good books, all the goodness will also go and be stored in the subconscious.
Tú haces cosas buenas y toda esa información se va a guardar en el subconsciente.
So get the children, get ourselves, think good, see good, hear good, all the time. And as I explained, everything is to help us to learn. So we have to put in a lot of values into our own heart. And that will program ourselves be a good person. Don't tell yourself things that are negative.
No se digan a sí mismo que las cosas son negativas.
When you have problems, don't say, oh, I'm so unlucky, oh, why do you have problems?
Cuando tengan problemas, no se digan, oh, soy tan infeliz, tengo tantos problemas.
We teach ourselves, think in a positive way.
Nosotros nos enseñamos a nosotros mismos, pensemos de forma positiva.
When problems come, oh, I'm so happy I have problems, I will learn from it, I will solve problems, I will become more clever.
Cuando lleguen los problemas, digamos, estoy tan feliz que el problema ha llegado, voy a aprender a través de esto y a ser más libre.
You have obstacles, I will overcome obstacles, I will win.
Y si tenemos obstáculos, voy a sobreponerme a los obstáculos y voy a ganar.
When you think in a positive way, you will start to help you interpret everything in a positive way, and you will become happy, peaceful, and successful. But the television, the surrounding, is destroying us. So learn to teach yourself discrimination. We've got to discriminate between things that are good for us, things that are bad for us. So now, how do we solve all these problems in our life? The only way is to learn to raise our consciousness higher.
La única forma es aprendiendo a elevar nuestra conciencia a niveles más elevados.
when you raise our consciousness higher, we start to be in contact with the super conscious mind.
Cuando lo hacemos, comenzamos a entrar en contacto con nuestra mente supraconsciente.
We all have this super conscious mind.
Nosotros tenemos esta mente supraconsciente.
This is where we have our conscience.
Ahí es donde tenemos nuestra conciencia.
The conscience will guide us and tell us, this is good, you can do it. This is not good, don't do it.
La conciencia nos va a decir, esto está bien, hazlo, esto no está bien, no lo hagas.
We start to get intuition, knowledge, within our own self.
Vamos a comenzar a tener intuición, conocimiento dentro de nosotros mismos.
If you can raise your consciousness to the superconscious, you start to know everything for yourself. So, I just want to show you some example of how I teach my children. We get the children to sit in prayers and meditation to raise the consciousness
higher.
And they become very good children, full of love and compassion. They are so calm, they become really beautiful children. And the government of Thailand, they give us all the top prizes for making children with good character. But at the same time, all of our students can get into universities
100%.
They get all the top prizes in education. They're very clever people. So by training your mind, you become very clever as well. But the most important thing is that they're good people, full of love and compassion. So this is an experiment done at Berkeley, University of California at Berkeley.
Este es un experimento realizado en la Universidad de Berkeley, California.
They taught meditation on how to concentrate the mind.
Ellos aprendían meditación o cómo concentrar la mente.
And they measured the effect of that concentration.
Y medían el efecto de esa concentración.
Those who have never practiced any meditation or concentration exercises, they measure the ability to remember, memory.
Ellos tenían la habilidad de memorizar y ellos nunca habían tenido una meditación.
Those who have never practiced, the memory was measured at 40%.
La memoria en ellos se medía en 40%.
People who have practiced meditation or concentration exercises for 1 year, the memory increased to 60%.
Y aquellos que lo habían hecho por 1 año, su memoria se incrementaba en un 60%.
So, from failed in their examinations, now they pass very easily. And those who have practiced for 2 years, the memory increased to 70%. So this shows very clearly that you can train your mind to be calm and still, then you have better memory. Look at Sir Isaac Newton. You know, I was so fortunate. I went up to study my bachelor's degree and master's degree at Cambridge University in England. And I had a room right next to the room of Sir Isaac Newton. But he was there before me, 300 years before me. So the room was built 500 years ago. So I felt very happy that I had a room right next to his room. And I loved to go and sit underneath an apple tree. I kept on waiting. When is the apple going to fall on me? It never fell on me. But in case of Newton, the apple fell. Suddenly he discovered the laws of motion, the law of gravity, and so on. He didn't discover things in the laboratory. He was not doing any research. He was sitting silently, quite still, underneath the apple tree. The apple fell down, and suddenly he said, "Oh, I know." So, look at Albert Einstein. He's the greatest scientist in the past century. UNESCO announced that he is the most, the best scientist of that of the last century. But when he studied in school, he did not study well. He tried to get into a university in Germany, but he couldn't get into a university. Finally, he studied in a technical college in Berlin. So people gave hope, gave up hope that this man will become a great scientist. Later on, he became the greatest scientist ever. How could he achieve that? Well, these are his words.
La intuición no es el resultado de una intención o de un ejercicio programado, porque proviene directamente del corazón.
It's intuition, knowledge that suddenly came to him.
Es intuición, es el conocimiento que de repente aparece en él.
When the mind is calm, you start to get intuition.
Cuando la mente está en calma, ustedes comienzan a tener intuición.
So this is very important to train children to grow up with a calm mind, steady mind.
Eso es muy importante, enseñar a los estudiantes a crecer con una mente tranquila.
You know this spacecraft?
¿Conocen esta nave espacial?
This was the first spacecraft that landed on Mars in the history of mankind.
Esta es la primera nave que aterrizó en Marte en la historia de la humanidad.
The Viking spacecraft.
Esta es la estación de la nave Viking.
Before that, no spacecraft was successful in the landing on any planet.
Antes de eso, ninguna nave fue exitosa en aterrizar en ninguna parte.
Well, I got a PhD in engineering, and I went to the United States just to brush up on the latest technology.
Yo obtuve un grado, un PhD en ingeniería y fui a los Estados Unidos para tener una actualización en los últimos conocimientos.
They announced this project.
Y ellos anunciaron este proyecto.
So I applied with NASA. I want to work and help you.
Yo apliqué con la NASA y les dije, quiero trabajar y ayudar.
You know what they said to me?
¿Saben lo que me dijeron?
Sorry, we do not accept aliens. In America, they use the word aliens for foreigners.
En América usan la voz aliens, que significa extraterrestres, para los extranjeros.
In England, they would use foreigners, not aliens.
En Inglaterra usarán foreigners, que significa extranjeros.
Anyway, they did not accept foreigners.
Ellos no aceptaban extranjeros.
So I thought to myself, the Indian people working in NASA. The Chinese people working in NASA. How could they get in? So I studied the whole thing and I realized that they will only accept me on one condition. And that is, if they cannot find any American to do that job, they will accept a foreigner. So I studied about this project. And I discovered there's only one thing the Americans have never succeeded. Up to that time, they have not been able to land any spacecraft on any planets to have a soft landing on those planets. Every time spacecraft go to these planets, it would crash landed. So I applied again and I said I'm going to help build something that will control the descent of the spacecraft and make soft landing on the planet. This time they interested, they invited me for an interview. But on the same day there were four other Americans who also were asking for this job to control the descent. So NASA told me, we are very sorry, but you have to be the last person that we are going to interview. We have to choose Americans first. So I said, I will wait. And they start to interview the Americans. They have all been involved in space projects. They have built spacecraft to make it land on various planets. And they all crashed onto the surface of the planets. So the interviewer said, oh, you built it, but you failed, you failed, you failed, you failed. All the four of them have been failed, have been failing. Only one person has never failed. Because he has never built anything before, so how can he fail? They didn't have any choice. So they asked me to help in the project. So I started to do a lot of research. Here was I in California doing some research there. And they are willing to finance a lot of money, no problem, any machine, anything I want, they give to me. I tried, I built several of these instruments that will help with the control. But they all failed. After 1 year, I built four times, they failed four times. So I thought to myself, maybe I'm doing the research in the wrong way. So I decided to change the way of doing my research. I went up on top of the mountain in California. And I sat there silently in meditation. I calmed my mind so that it's still. When the mind is calm and still, suddenly you get inspiration. You start to get intuition. Knowledge just comes when your mind is calm and still. So suddenly I knew what to do. I came running back to the laboratories. It's a long way, so I didn't run. I had a car and I drove back to the laboratories. And then I built it for them. They tested. They said, oh, it's working, it's working. They asked me to build three such machines. I built it for them, and they incorporated in Viking spacecraft number 1, number 2, and number 3, three of them. Then I said, bye-bye, I've got to go back because I'm a professor at university in Thailand. They said, no, we want you to stay. I said, I'm sorry, I must go back. They said, they will give me US citizenship immediately.
me iba a dar la nacionalidad americana inmediatamente.
I said, I love Thailand, my country, I don't want to be an American.
Yo amo mi país, Tailandia, y no quiero ser un americano.
So they decided to increase my salary many times.
Me ofrecieron subir mi salario muchas veces.
I said, sorry, I don't need so much money in Thailand.
Lo siento, no necesito tanto dinero en Tailandia.
So they told me, we'll give you a project to do.
Y me dijeron, te vamos a dar un proyecto para que lo hagas.
We're going to build a plane that can never be shot down by the enemies.
Que vas a construir un avión que nunca pueda ser disparado por los enemigos.
I laughed.
Yo me reí.
If I build this for the Americans, they'll shoot down everybody and they're not shot down themselves.
Si yo construyo esto para los americanos, van a dispararle a todo el mundo, pero no nadie le va a disparar a ellos.
It's very easy actually, but why should I build it for them?
Es muy fácil, ¿por qué debería hacerlo?
I tell you the secret, don't go and tell the Americans.
Yo le voy a decir el secreto, no se lo vayan a decir a los americanos.
When the plane is flying at a very fast speed,
cuando un avión está volando a una velocidad muy rápida,
you can always catch that plane using a radar.
Siempre puedes captar ese avión usando un radar.
You send microwave signals, it comes back, and then you know exactly the position of the plane.
Mandas una microonda que capta donde está el avión y regresa y marca la posición.
So you shoot up a guided missile.
Y disparas un misil guiado.
And we connect to the plane, we know all the time where it is.
Lo conectamos al avión y el va a saber siempre dónde está.
So the missile will hit the plane and then be shot down.
Así que el misil va a disparar al avión donde se encuentra.
So the way to prevent that from happening,
lo que va a prevenir de que eso suceda,
is to receive the signal, change the signal, send it back immediately. You can do this at the speed of light.
Y es recibir la señal, cambiar la señal y devolverla. Y esto sucede a la velocidad de la luz.
And when you change the signal, you are telling these people that we are over there, not here.
Y cuando cambian la señal, dicen que estamos allá y no aquí.
Then they send us a missile in accordance with that information.
Cuando mandan una información para un misil, con de acuerdo a esa información.
So it goes to a different position than the one we are in.
Va a llegar a una posición distinta de la que nosotros nos encontramos.
So they can't shoot us.
No nos pueden disparar.
But don't tell them the secret. So anyway, they finally set up the rocket from Cape
Canaveral.
Two rockets.
No cohete.
With Viking number one, Viking number two.
Viking 1 and Viking 2.
The third one is in the museum.
El tercero es en el museo.
So they traveled. It took almost 11 months to get to Mars. It's a long, long way away compared to the moon. You know, we send a rocket to the moon, we send it today, tomorrow it's there already. Here it took 11 months. Then it started to go around, orbit around Mars.
Comenzó a ir alrededor de la órbita de Marte.
And finally, they sent a signal which stimulated the machine that I built, and that helped in the landing process.
Y entonces mandaron una señal que estimuló la máquina que diseñó y comenzó el proceso de amortizar.
And finally, they landed safely on the surface of Mars.
Y finalmente aterrizó a salvo en la.
This is Viking number one, actual photograph of Viking number one.
Esta es una fotografía real de Viking 1.
This is Viking number two.
Este es número dos.
Both landed safely on the surface of Mars for the first time in the history of mankind.
Y ambos aterrizaron a salvo por primera vez en la historia de la humanidad.
And the Americans, they celebrated.
Y los americanos celebraron.
Because it was very close to 4th of July,
1976.
4th of July they celebrate Independence Day. 1976 was exactly 200 years from that independence. So they really celebrated the landing of the Viking spacecraft on Mars.
Así que realmente celebraron la aterrizaje de la nave de los humanos.
They did not mention that there was a Thai person from Thailand who built this boat.
Ellos no mencionaron que era una persona de Tailandia la que construyó esto aquí.
But the embassy, U.S. embassy in Thailand, they announced it.
Pero la embajada americana en Tailandia lo anunció.
So I had to give a lot of interviews on television and so on in Thailand. So you see, when we practice meditation, we start to control our mind.
Cuando nosotros practicamos la meditación, comenzamos a controlar.
And we start to know things for ourselves. We get intuition, knowledge, wisdom, understanding.
Tener la intuición, el conocimiento y una conocimiento es por sabiduría.
And when we do that, we start to have a lot of knowledge and understanding and intuition.
Y cuando hacemos eso, comenzamos a tener un montón de conocimiento y comprensión e intuición.
And the last thing I want to mention is that we also have the sixth sense.
Y lo último que quiero señalar es que tenemos el sexto sentido.
Sometimes we can feel what others are thinking, what are they doing, how they are feeling.
A veces podemos sentir lo que uno está pensando, lo que está sintiendo, lo que está haciendo.
I teach children all the time now.
Yo les enseño a los niños todo el tiempo.
And the children, they feel my love.
Y los niños sienten mi amor.
They feel so peaceful when they're with me. All the children, they come and embrace me. They're so happy when they can feel this. And this is the sixth sense. We can inspire people a lot. I give a lot of love to the children and they all are inspired. And they become very good children.
Y se convierten en niños muy buenos.
They're full of joy, happiness, and kindness.
Están llenos de gozo, de felicidad.
So we've got to train ourselves to raise our consciousness, then we start to inspire other people.
Así que nosotros tenemos que enseñarnos a nosotros mismos a elevar nuestra conciencia y así poder inspirar a otras personas.
So we've got to understand about teaching other people.
Así que tenemos que aprender cómo enseñar a otras personas.
You know, we have amor, love, which has to be transmitted to other people.
Tenemos amor, pues debe ser transferido.
And when you have love, you start to feel a lot of joy, happiness, and we start to do everything in the correct way. We have right action.
Cuando tenemos el amor, entonces vamos a aprovechar la felicidad y hacer buenas cosas de la forma correcta, la rectitud.
And when you have a lot of love in your heart, you feel tremendous peace, joy and happiness.
Cuando tienes amor en tu corazón, tienes una paz tremenda, gozo, felicidad.
So you start to have peace within yourself.
A sentir paz dentro.
When you have a lot of love, then you raise your consciousness higher.
Y cuando tienes mucho amor,
then you start to understand the truth.
Comienzas a comprender la verdad.
You start to understand everything.
Comienzas a comprender todo.
There's no more secret in the universe.
Ya no hay más secretos en el universo.
You are able to find out anything you want.
Somos capaces de poder encontrar todo aquello que queramos.
Because the truth comes from the superconscious.
Porque la verdad viene de la supraconsciencia.
So this is very important.
Esto es muy importante.
And when we have a lot of love, you can never have any violence. These are the five human values. We really practice
to
understand this process of learning. You become a human being who is fully developed.
Ustedes se convierte en seres humanos que están totalmente desarrollados.
So it doesn't matter which profession you are going to be in.
No importa en qué profesión ustedes se encuentren.
You learn to understand yourself. Know thyself.
Si ustedes aprenden a conocerse a ustedes mismos, conócete a ti mismo.
You know, Socrates told all of us, man, know thyself.
Sócrates nos dijo, hombre, conócete a ti mismo.
But we don't understand ourselves.
Pero nosotros no entendemos eso.
People are lost in the world because we don't know who we are.
Las personas están perdidas en el mundo porque no sabemos quiénes somos.
And when you don't know who we are, you don't know where we are going.
Si tú no sabes quién eres, no sabes hacia dónde vas.
You don't understand the purpose of life.
No comprendes el propósito de la vida.
So you waste your life by doing this, doing that, and wasting everything because you don't know the purpose of life.
Y así desperdicias tu vida haciendo esto o aquello porque no sabes el propósito de la vida.
So I just want to remind you, since I have to finish the talk.
Así que solo quería recordarte todo lo que debo terminar la charla.
Understand yourself.
Compréndanse a ustedes mismos.
Who are we?
¿Quiénes somos?
Why are we here on this earth?
¿Por qué estamos en esta tierra?
Where are we going?
¿Hacia dónde vamos?
If you don't understand this, you just waste your life.
Porque si no comprendemos eso, solamente desperdiciamos nuestra vida.
So please think carefully.
Por lo tanto, piensen que...
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Niños muy miedosos, los niños serán muy miedosos.
And
order to solve that problem, we got the children to raise the consciousness high.
Y para solucionar eso debemos hacer que los niños eleven su conciencia.
Then they have protection from their superconscious mind.
Entonces el niño va a tener la protección de la mente supraconsciente.
The superconscious mind will help the children to have discrimination.
La mente supraconsciente les va a ayudar a los niños a tener discriminación.
And this is something that we have to train our children to learn to discriminate.
Y eso es lo que nosotros tenemos que enseñarles a los niños, a aprender a discernir.
Children have to ask, is this good for me or is it bad for me?
Y el niño debe preguntar, ¿es esto bueno para mí o es esto malo para mí?
If it's good for me, then you can do it.
Si es bueno para mí, lo voy a hacer.
If it's not good for me, reject it.
Y si es malo, lo voy a rechazar.
So this fundamental discrimination is so important, and the only way is to raise the consciousness higher.
Esta discriminación fundamental es tan importante, y la única manera es elevando la conciencia a nivel superior.
La intuición tiene que ver con los sueños o con el conocimiento.
La ilusión.
Intuición.
Sí.
The real intuition,
la intuición verdadera,
is through consciousness, but the higher consciousness.
Es a través de la conciencia, pero la conciencia superior.
In your dreams, you are collecting information from your subconscious.
En los sueños, tú estás recolectando información del subconsciente.
Because the subconscious does not sleep.
Porque el subconsciente no duerme.
It functions all the time.
Funciona todo el tiempo.
You can teach children while they're sleeping.
Puedes enseñarle a los niños mientras duermen.
If you play tapes in English, they will start to remember everything because it's put into the subconscious.
Tú tocas cassettes en inglés, va a comenzar a manifestarse porque está guardado en el subconsciente.
We call this sleep learning.
Esto es lo que llamamos aprendizaje en el sueño.
So you can teach children to speak good English by getting them to listen to tapes while they're sleeping.
Puedes enseñarle a los niños a hablar buen inglés haciéndolos escuchar cassettes mientras duermen.
They wake up and they start to speak English in a better way.
Y se despiertan y comienzan a hablar el inglés de mejor manera.
But that is not, that is different from the superconscious mind.
Pero eso es diferente de la mente supraconsciente.
The superconscious mind knows everything.
La mente supraconsciente conoce todo.
There's no secret from the superconscious mind.
No hay secreto para la mente supraconsciente.
We are the knower.
Nosotros somos el conocedor.
We know everything.
Conocemos todo.
But it has to be the superconscious mind.
Pero tiene que ser la mente supraconsciente.
So great people in the world, they have to raise their consciousness, discover their true self.
La gente en el mundo debe elevar su conciencia y descubrir su propio ser.
That is the superconscious mind.
Y esa es la mente supraconsciente.
And they will be able to answer everything. They will know everything for themselves.
Y podrán contestar todo porque van a saber todo por sí.
They become an enlightened being.
Y te convierte en una mente iluminada.
Many saints, many great people, they are able to get into this superconscious mind.
Muchos santos, mucha gente elevada, se entrenó para llegar a este nivel de tratamiento supra.
So the subconscious is only a memory.
La subconsciencia es solo una memoria.
It will remember things for you.
Va a traer recuerdos para ti.
But you still got to train. You can have a lot of information, but you've forgotten everything.
Tú puedes entrenarla, pero vas a tener mucha información, pero puedes olvidarla todo.
Just like memory in the computer.
Es como la memoria en una computadora.
You must learn to draw out the information to the screen. Then you will understand, the computer will start to understand.
Tú debes aprender a traer la información a la pantalla y entonces tú vas a poder comprender.
Most of the time, we don't remember what's in the computer.
La mayor parte del tiempo no recordamos qué hay en la computadora.
So we've got to draw it out.
Tenemos que volver a sacar.
Same with our subconscious, we have a lot of information.
Lo mismo con el subconsciente, tenemos demasiada, mucha información.
So we've got to learn to draw that out.
Nosotros tenemos que aprender a sacar.
And you've got to calm your mind, make it still, then information will start to come out. But what is important is that you have inner knowledge, wisdom and understanding. It's already there. We are not an ordinary person.
No somos personas ordinarias.
We are super beings.
Somos super seres.
But because we don't know ourselves, we don't understand all these things.
Pero como no nos conocemos, no comprendemos todo.
So one day we can all become a super human being.
Y algún día nos podemos comprender y convertir en un super ser
humano. But we have to train our mind.
Pero tenemos que entrenar nuestra mente.
Okay, so you understand the difference between subconscious, which is just the memory, and the knowledge that is already there everywhere.
Así que poder comprender la diferencia entre el subconsciente, que es solo memoria, y el conocimiento que está siempre.
Yo trabajo en un área muy conflictiva, ¿no? Tengo que hacer la atención directa con él, el paciente. Y muchos por sus condiciones de salud vienen muy molestos, ¿sí? Son agresivos, hasta me han insultado. ¿Él podría recomendarme alguna técnica de cómo manejar esto además de quedarme sorda? Porque a veces, sí, de verdad, a veces yo hago educación, ¿no? Los guío de la misma manera, pero insisten, entonces a veces ya... Lo concluyo y continúo con la siguiente persona. Entonces igual se pone molesto porque le dejé de prestar atención y quiero que esté todo el tiempo escuchando lo que me dice. Entonces a veces no sé cómo actuar de la mejor manera.
Instead, we have to think of that person who is saying bad things at you.
Pero al mismo tiempo tenemos que pensar en esa persona que te está insultando.
That person is suffering.
Está sufriendo.
So that's why they are crazy or they're mad or they think this and that all the time.
Por eso están locos y están pensando ese tipo de cosas todo el tiempo.
So you see the patient in a different light.
Entonces tú vas a ver al paciente desde una luz distinta.
They are suffering, they are unhappy.
Ellos están sufriendo, son infelices.
So we got to give them some kind of love and happiness.
Tenemos que darles algo de amor y felicidad.
Keep calm.
Mantente calma.
Then you send out love to that person.
Y envíale amor a esa persona.
And that will calm the mind of the patient.
Y eso va a calmar la mente del paciente.
If you are upset, oh, why is he swearing at me? Why is he saying bad things at me? You start to send negative feeling to that person.
Pero si tú te comienzas a preocupar y dices, ¿por qué me está diciendo esto? Y acá estamos enviándole sentimientos negativos a otra persona.
Then the situation will get worse.
Y la situación se va a empeorar.
So calm your mind.
Calma tu mente.
Understand that the patient is suffering.
Entiende que el paciente está sufriendo.
That's why he's complaining, that's why he's saying things all the time.
Y eso es el motivo por el que está quejando y diciendo cosas todo el tiempo.
So this love, this compassion from the medical doctor is so important.
Este amor y esta compasión del médico es muy importante.
Well, when I went back to Thailand,
yo regresé a Tailandia.
I became a professor at Chulalongkorn University.
Yo me convertí,
the faculty of engineering.
Yo me convertí en un profesor de la Universidad de Chulalongkorn en ingeniería.
And you know, I did not teach a lot of engineering.
Yo no enseñaba mucho ingeniería.
I taught all the students in all the faculties.
Yo le enseñaba a todos los estudiantes en todas las facultades.
Including the faculty of medicine.
Incluida la facultad de medicina.
And I taught them how to understand your own mind.
Y les enseñaba cómo comprender su propia mente.
I taught them to be good people, full of love and compassion.
Y les enseñaba a ser buena gente llena de amor y compasión.
And you know, they changed and they became very good people.
Y cambiaron y se convirtieron en gente muy buena.
One of my students was studying to become a doctor.
Uno de mis estudiantes estaba estudiando para ser un doctor.
And that doctor now is the greatest doctor in Thailand.
Y ese doctor ahora es el más grande doctor de Tailandia.
He understands people very well.
Y él entiende a la gente muy bien.
And he was able to treat many people in the correct way.
Y él fue capaz de tratar a muchas personas de la forma correcta.
Because he understands himself.
Porque él se comprende a sí mismo.
This is something that we got to understand. We got to understand ourselves.
Eso es lo que tenemos que llegar a comprender. Tenemos que comprendernos a nosotros mismos.
If you don't understand yourself, you don't understand anybody.
Si no te comprendes a ti misma, no puedes comprender a nadie más.
So I taught all the students and all the faculties how to meditate, how to really understand themselves.
Si yo les enseñaba a todos los estudiantes en todas las facultades cómo meditar y cómo comprenderse.
And now they are wonderful people in society.
Y ahora son gente maravillosa en la sociedad.
¿Cómo se reinventó cuando trabajó en la NASA? Ya había fallado por 4 ocasiones. ¿Cómo se replanteó esta idea de la nación, de la intuición? ¿Y si esta técnica se le podría también enseñar a convictos?
¿A qué?
A convictos.
¿Convictos? ¿Convictos?
¿Presos? Yes, NASA had failed to land spacecrafts on any planet.
Sí, la NASA había fallado para aterrizar naves en cualquier planeta.
They all crash landed on the surface of all the planets.
Se estrellaban contra la superficie de todos los planetas.
So, without landing softly, they cannot bring out information from those planets.
Y sin aterrizar suavemente, no podían traer información de sus planetas.
You ask how I got the information to solve the problem, right?
Tú preguntas cómo yo tuve la información para solucionar el problema. ¿Es eso correcto?
I sat in meditation on top of a mountain. And I raised the consciousness towards the super consciousness.
Yo me senté en meditación. Eleve la conciencia a la superconciencia.
And when you reach up to the super consciousness, this is the knower. It knows everything. We all have this within ourselves.
Y cuando tú elevas la conciencia a la superconciencia, este es el conocedor y conoce todo.
You suddenly get intuition and knowledge.
Y de repente tienes la intuición y el conocimiento.
So I was sitting on top of a mountain in California. Just calm my mind so that it's still concentrated.
Y que sentado en una montaña de California solo calme mi mente para que esté tranquila y concentrada.
And you start to get intuition knowledge by yourself.
Y comenzaste a tener el conocimiento intuitivo por ti mismo.
And I knew exactly how to build this thing so that it will take this Viking spacecraft down onto the surface successfully.
Y comprendí cómo debía construir este dispositivo para llevar la nave de Viking a la superficie.
It's a second condition.
The second one is that if you can teach this technique.
Perfect.
Well, I go to jail quite often.
You will a cancel PMA?
Not as a convict, no, but I've been asked to go and teach convicts.
Porque me han pedido que vaya y les enseñe a los convictos.
So I do that already.
Yo ya lo hago.
In many jails in Thailand.
En muchas cárceles en Tailandia.
And I teach them to have a lot of love in their heart.
Les enseño a tener mucho amor en su corazón.
They got to learn to calm their mind.
Tienen que aprender a calmar su mente.
When the mind is calm, they become a good person automatically.
Cuando su mente está tranquila, ellos se convierten en una buena persona automáticamente.
It's only when the mind is not steady, is not calm, that they commit a lot of offenses.
Solamente cuando la mente no está calmada, porque está inquieta, que cometen una gran cantidad de ofensas.
So I teach them meditation.
Si quieres, enseño la meditación.
And a lot of them have become good people as a result.
Y muchos de ellos se han convertido en buenas personas.
So yes, you can teach convicts.
Sí, puedes enseñarle a los convictos.
You can teach anybody.
Puedes enseñarle a cualquier persona.
The most difficult people that I try to teach and they're not very good at it.
La gente más difícil a la que he tratado de enseñarles y que no son buenos en eso.
Are the politicians. I thought of teaching politicians.
Yo traté de enseñarle a los políticos.
So I competed in the election to become a politician.
Así que competí en las elecciones para ser un político.
I won the election. I was a member of parliament for 3 consecutive terms.
Yo gané las elecciones y fui miembro del parlamento por 3 ocasiones consecutivas.
And I tried to teach the politicians.
Y traté de enseñarle a los políticos.
They don't listen to me. Very difficult people.
Gente muy teach.
Children are the easiest.
Los niños son los más fáciles.
So that's why I'm now teaching only children.
Y eso es el motivo porque ahora solo enseño.
They are wonderful people.
Son gente maravillosa.
Usted también.
Gracias.